I'm waiting for everyone to get in and get ready. It's unbelievable. I'll send that through when I send the people arriving shots. Yeah. Everyone stand still for a minute, please.
Conclusion of the ceremony, but for now, let's go live to Christchurch.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة
نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا إنه من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله سبحانه وتعالى وأسأل الله عز وجل أن يتقبل الشهداء مع الصديقين والشهداء والصالحين إنه سميع قريب مجيب الدعاء أما بعد أيها الإخوة المسلمون Brothers and sisters in Islam Brothers and sisters in humanity, brothers and sisters in New Zealand, last Friday I stood in this mosque and saw hatred and rage in the eyes of the terrorists. Who killed and martyred 50 innocent people, wounded 42, and broke the hearts of millions around the world. Today, from the same place, I look out and I see the love and compassion in the eyes of thousands of fellow New Zealanders and human beings from across the globe that fill the hearts of millions more who are not with us physically but in spirit. This terrorist sought to tear our nation apart with an evil ideology that has torn the world apart. But Instead, we have shown that New Zealand is unbreakable and that the world can see in us but instead we have shown that New Zealand is unbreakable and that the world can see in us an example of love and unity. We are broken-hearted, but we are not broken. We are alive. We are together. We are determined to not let anyone divide us. We are determined to love one another and to support each other. This evil ideology of white supremacy did not strike us first, yet it struck us hardest. The number of people killed is not ordinary, but the solidarity in New Zealand is extraordinary. To the families of the victims, your loved ones did not die in vain. Their blood has watered the seeds of hope. Through them, the world will see the beauty of Islam and the beauty of our unity. And Allah, the Almighty, says in the Holy Quran,
وَلَا تَحْسَبَنَّ الَّذِينَ قُتِلُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ أَمْوَاتٍ وَلَا تَحْسَبَنَّ الَّذِينَ قُتِلُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ أَمْوَاتٍ بل أحياء بل أحياء ولكن لا تشعرون.
Do not say of those who have been killed in the way of Allah that they are dead. They are alive, rejoicing with their Lord. They were the best of us, taken from us on the best of days, in the best of places, and performing the best of actions. And they are not just martyrs of Islam, but they are martyrs of this nation, New Zealand. Our loss of you is a gain to New Zealand's unity and strength. Your departure is an awakening not just for our nation, but for all humanity. Your martyrdom is a new life for New Zealand and a chance of prosperity for many. Our assembly here, with all the shades of our diversity, is a testament of our joint humanity. We are here in our hundreds and thousands unified for one purpose. That hate will be undone and love will redeem us. We are taught by our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam that you can never truly show gratitude to the Almighty God if you are incapable of thanking your fellow man. To the people of New Zealand, thank you. Thank you for your tears. Thank you for your haka. Thank you for your flowers. Thank you for your love and compassion. To our Prime Minister, thank you. Thank you for your leadership. It has been a lesson for the world's leaders. Thank you for holding our families close and honoring us with a simple scarf. Thank you for your words and tears of compassion. Thank you for being one with us. Thank you to the New Zealand government and to all the wonderful people who have shown us that we matter and are not forgotten. Thank you to our police force and frontline services. You put our lives before your own every day. Thank you to the neighbors who opened their doors to save us from the killer. Thank you to those who pulled over their cars to help us. Thank you to those who brought us food and helped us when we found it difficult to stand. Thank you. Thank you, New Zealand, for teaching the world what it means to love and care. To my brothers, ancestors, those who are here today to perform the weekly Friday prayer, thank you for coming together once again. It is easy to feel lost after the trauma you and I experienced. But the promise of Allah made to us is true.
وبشر الصابرين وبشر الصابرين الذين إذا أصابتهم مصيبة قالوا إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون.
Give glad news to the patient. Those when afflicted, they say, to Allah we all belong, and to Him we shall return. They are those upon whom God's mercy descends. Thank you for your strength and your forgiveness. Thank you for your anger that is restrained and for your mercy that is overflowing. Thank you for your steadfastness and standing tall when many others would fall. Thank you. Ud'u Allah yastajib lakum. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونصلي على نبيه محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وآل بيته الكرام وأصحابه الغر الميامين. أما بعد، إسلاموفوبيا كيلز. Muslims have felt its pain for many years. It has killed before in Canada, and its brutality was used against teens in Norway and against innocent Muslims in the UK, USA, and other countries around the world. Islamophobia is real. It's a targeted campaign to influence people to dehumanize and irrationally fear Muslims, to fear what we wear, to fear the choice of food we eat, to fear the way we pray, and to fear the way we practice our faith. We call upon governments around the world, including New Zealand and the neighboring countries, to bring an end to hate speech and the politics of fear. The martyrdom of 50 innocent people and the injury of 42 last Friday did not come overnight. It was the result of the anti-Islamic and anti-Muslim rhetoric by some political leaders, some media agencies, and others. Last week's event is proof and evidence to the entire world that terrorism has no color, has no race, and has no religion. The rise of white supremacy and right-wing extremism is a great global threat to mankind, and this must end now. I want to take this opportunity to to thank my Muslim and non-Muslim brothers and sisters for attending today. And I would like also to thank our international guests who are with us and had come to our support and aid in these difficult times. Allahumma ighfir lil mu'mineen wal mu'minat wal muslimin wal muslimat al ahya'i minhum wal amwat innaka sami'un qareebun mujibud da'awati ya rabbal alamin. Allahumma ighfir lil shuhada وارفعهم في عليين مع الصديقين والشهداء والصالحين واشف الجرحى والمصابين وأنزل الصبر علينا جميعا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين واحفظ بلدنا نيوزيلندا وأهلها أجمعين. O Allah, have mercy upon us all. O Allah, have mercy upon those who were massacred last week. O Allah, grant to them the highest level of paradise. O Allah, grant to the injured a speedy recovery and grant to the families of the victims patience. O Allah, grant our nation and country New Zealand peace, security, and protect it and its people from all evils. O Allah, grant the entire world peace, security, and prosperity. O Allah, protect New Zealand. O Allah, protect New Zealanders and the world. Ameen, ameen. Wa aqim as-salah. Inna as-salata tanha an al-fahsha'i wal-munkar. Wa la dhikrullahi akbar. Wallahu ya'lamu ma tasna'un.
Straighten ourselves, come closer. Bismillah. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وبشر الصابرين الذين إذا أصابتهم مصيبة قالوا
إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون أولئك عليهم صلوات من ربهم ورحمة وأولئك هم المهتدون الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمدا الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمدا السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم I greet you with the Islamic greeting of peace. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuhu. Our Imam Jamal summed up our feelings in New Zealand, the Muslims of New Zealand, and our country in New Zealand. So I'm not going to take any more of your time because from here we are going to go and start our own burial. I would like to conclude in the language of the people of New Zealand, the Tangata Whenua. I will use the words of love. Aroha, aroha, aroha. Kaifaka kotahi tatu. Kaifaka kotahi tatu. kaifaka kotahi tatu. Salamu alaikum. Inshallah, burial will start at 4 o'clock at the cemetery. The mass burial will start at 4 o'clock at the cemetery. Everybody is welcome.
Well, right now you are with One News Special. The Prime Minister there, we can see, making her way out of the Friday prayers. With me is Masuma Mehdi, the Imam there, a powerful speech. Some powerful words in there. We heard the Imam say, through love and compassion, New Zealand is unbreakable. Terrorism has no colour, no race, no religion. What did you take out of that speech?
Well, the words were really summarizing the feelings of all the Muslims around New Zealand. I think what touched my heart the most was when he addressed those who killed as martyrs. And I just would like to emphasize that martyrs have a very special place in Islam. And we do believe that each drop of their blood is gone unwasted. And I can see enemies.